be different.
Well, how do you do? This is
something sort of unusual in the way of hillbilly music.
I don't understand most of the new country music. I really don't care for it.
Fried chicken farts and blessing hearts. Here comes that gravy boat with Dave Stone.
Oh, how about you? It is the gravy boat. Great show lined up for you today. Let's get it going with a little John Anderson. Swing it, son.
There's a little girl in our neighborhood. Her name is Charlotte Johnson, and she's really looking good. I had to go and see her, so I called her on the phone. I walked over to her house, and this was going on. Her brother was on the sofa eating chocolate pie. Her mama was in the kitchen cutting chicken up to fry. Daddy was in the backyard rolling up a garden hose. I was on the porch with Charlotte, feeling love down to my toes, and we were swinging.
Swinging.
Yeah, just a swinging. Charlotte, she's as pretty as the angels when they sang. I can't believe I'm out here on the front porch in the swing. A swinging. A darling, she's the apple of my eye. When I'm on the swing with her, she makes me almost high. Charlotte is my lover, she has been since the spring. Just can't believe it started on the front porch in the swing. We were swinging, yeah, just a swinging. Little Charlotte, she's as pretty as the angels when they sing. I'm out here on the front porch in the swing, a swinging. I said, little Charlotte, she's as pretty as the angels when they sing. I can't believe I'm out here on the front porch in the swing, a swinging.
Yeah. S-W-I-N-D-I-N. You know, like John Anderson, you could just get out of my yard. From 1982's Wild and Blue, John Anderson with Swangin'. That was my childhood, my earliest years of listening and comprehending and understanding what I was listening to as far as country music in the backseat of my parents' 78 Oldsmobile. I do remember that one having quite an impact. Such a fun little sing-along. Hey, we're swinging. I like to think that it's just literal, like, that there's no... Based on the lyrical content, I don't think that there's any innuendo there with the other usage of the word. It's just him and Charlotte Johnson. There's no third party involved or fourth party, so I think we're good on that. All right, that's enough of that, Dave. It is the Gravy Boat. Episode 3 of Season 2. Thank you so much for tuning back in. If you've listened before, I appreciate that. If you're a first-time listener, hop on board. Get in, sit down, shut up, and hang on. We're going to have a good time. Tell a friend. Not a lot of outlets for this type of music. Can't just turn on any old radio station or whatever and hear this stuff. I mean, yeah, you can make your own playlists and stuff, but you're not going to get the charm and the hilarity of your humble host here on your own little... Got a good one lined up for you today. We're going to do some Robbie Fulks. We'll do something new from J.D. Wilkes. And right now, I always do truckers. Let's do some solo. Let's do some Patterson Hood from Heat Lightning, Rumbles in the Distance. A song called Disappear. It's on the Gravy Boat. Appreciate you.
at all. As the very last drop smashed against the wall, out in the driveway, accusing words fall out. I'm underneath your dress, beneath the bedroom window. Sometimes I disappear. I learned to at an early age. Before your very eyes, I'm somewhere far away. And if I make it down, for a landing, I'll kiss you till it's August, fly away in June.
Fowl, and when there's no fowl, we ate crawdad. And when there was no crawdad to be found, we ate sand.
You ate what?
We ate sand.
You ate sand?
That's right.
I got drunk and I ate chicken. I ate chicken I found in my kitchen. Not just a leg and not just a wing. I'd like to let you know that. How long she been there? But
Hey there, you wild and wonderful people of the world. This is Austin Lucas, and you're listening to The Gravy Boat with Dave Stone.
Gravy Boat, Season 2, Episode 3. That's Austin Lucas from a couple years ago. Put out Between the Moon and the Midwest, a song called Unbroken Hearts. Austin Lucas, one of my favorite new, I mean, not new, he's been around, he's been doing this thing for a while, new to me. Brought to my attention last year by my buddy Ryan Singer, great comedian Ryan Singer. He and Austin did a nice little tour. Was it last fall, I guess? Nice little kind of a house party type tour. They traveled all over the East Coast and the Midwest playing backyards and patios and dive bars, so it's a cool little combo. New album in the works, too. What I hear, very good. Should be out soon, Austin Lucas. For that, Those Darlings, The Whole Damn Thing. Love a song about eating a whole chicken. Like I've always said, nothing more satisfying than sit down eating a whole chicken. That's off their 2009 self-titled album, Those Darlings. Quick sad note. Fans of Those Darlings may know, or you may not know, last September, lead gal Jesse Zazu passed away of cervical cancer. 28. Ah, what a bummer. Screw cancer. Good Lord. But left behind several great albums, so check out Those Darlings and honor her legacy and her body of work. And kicking it off, Patterson Hood would disappear. Got a great one lined up for you. Anything you want to hear, feel free to holler at me. I'm on the Twitter at Dave Stone Comedy. So let me know. You know, I know quite a bit about this stuff, but I'm sure there's a lot of great bands I'm not familiar with. So holler at your boy. As promised, yet again from Purgatory, Tyler Childers. This one you haven't heard yet, at least on this show. Born Again. It's on the Gravy Boat. Enjoy.
Once I was
years.
After the hand, there was just the 80s, for a while. Drinking. Yeah, a lot of drinking.
Are you still drinking?
No. I don't. That's behind me now. Why are you buying?
Cocktails tore up my family. Cocktails tore down my home. One to wake me up every morning. One
found out pretty soon. It took two to wake me up every morning, two with my buddy at noon, two for the road every evening, till guess what happened pretty soon. Cocktails tore up my family, cocktails tore down my home. I cheated and I lied, swallowed my pride,
and then
washed it down with cocktails. Had a house on a hillside. The car I was driving was new. I had money in my pocket, but look what liquor made me do. I started running around with a woman, turned my back on my wife and my kid. Wonder how mama's gonna tell him the awful thing that daddy did. Cocktails tore up my family, cocktails tore down my home. I cheated and I lied, swallowed my pride,
and then
washed it down with cocktails.
Person I'm scared of make me warn you. I ain't never been scared of nobody. You're not really scared.
Take me back to the pine woods. Shackleton town, down by the river where the living is good and the buffalo's cool when the sun goes down. I left town when I turned 18. Gotta get away, gonna be a bigger man. Spent 20 years chasing a dream. Now I'm sitting here with my head in my hand. When it's over, pack me up in a box and take me back home to the Crusader Jones. Back home to the Crusader Jones. Stuck in traffic on my way to work. Been sitting for an hour, it felt like a year. Gonna go crazy if I don't die first. Gotta find a way to get the hell out of here. Back to the pine woods, back to the place that I know so well. Silly life is doing me no good, and a boss man's always giving me hell. Succeed a life in nothing but knocks, wear me down to a back full of bones. When it's over, pack me up in a box, take me back home to the Crusader Jones. Back home to the Crusader Jones.
Dixie State of John. Back home to the Dixie State of John. Back home to the Dixie State of John.
Welcome back to the Gravy Boat, episode 3 of season 2. That was Kerry Hudson, Free State of Jones. Before that, Robbie Fulks and Cocktails, kicking that set off with Tyler Childers, Born Again. Kerry Hudson, by the way, if you don't know, was in a great band called Blue Mountain. Put out several great albums starting in the 90s, Dog Days, Homegrown, a few others. Great band. That's the cool thing about this music. Well, I don't know if that's a cool thing or the bad thing. Depends on how you look at it. But there's so many artists that fly under the radar. And I guess that's bad, but it's also cool to be able to, you know, to turn you guys on and turn buddies on to, like, great bands that maybe they're not aware of. So Blue Mountain definitely falls under that category. Never got the acclaim that I thought they deserved. But anyway, Kerry Hudson going on to do a solo thing. And, boy, that song there, that's a good one. Off of Cool Breeze, his album from 2004, Free State of Jones. I was, in West Virginia, I would say 2010, doing a really crappy comedy show in the lobby of a Ramada Inn. Terrible show. Worked for a chain of terrible comedy clubs. I won't mention their name, Comedy Zone. But terrible show. Felt like I didn't do very well. I'm hanging out after the show. This guy comes up to him. He tells me how much he enjoyed the show. We start talking. He sounded and looked familiar. And I was like, man, I feel like I know this dude. And finally, I figured out it was Kerry Hudson. Yeah, he was at my comedy show for some reason in West Virginia. And seemed to like my work. So the feeling is mutual, Kerry Hudson. Keeping it going with Dave Alvin, a song called Abilene. It's on the Gravy Boat.
There's a greyhound bus leaving the great northwest, taking her tonight back down south to Texas. She's been dancing on tables to pay rent and be able to just get by and maybe stay clean. Abilene, Abilene, drunk, then he'd hit her hard, and her mama'd lie in bed high on pills and talking to God. But like her beautiful tattoos, these old memories she can't lose, since she ran away at 15. Abilene, Abilene, town ahead that you've never seen. Maybe it's better if you get off there and try to forget everything. Abilene, staring out the window at the long cold night, ahead on the horizon is another stirring of bright lights. But she's dreaming of a man she's going to meet in a bar on an Austin street. Maybe this one won't be so mean. Abilene, thinking of a girl he swore he'd wait there for. But he's drinking beers and he's feeling old, remembering every lie he's told, till he changes his mind and he leaves. Have a lane, have a lane. There's a town ahead there you've never seen. Maybe it's better if you get off there and try to forget it.
Take the Lord's name in vain when you're talking to a deacon of the church. Now,
I don't give a shit. You just sit here in your air-conditioned store while I cut weeds and fill potholes.
Your church can kiss my ass. The only reason y'all go to church is to show off new clothes. Don't think I don't know about stuff like that. You don't give a shit about Jesus. Jesus was a carpenter. He was like me. He worked for a living, building chairs.
Fresh pot every week, even if there's some left over.
Well, I woke up this morning looking for kicks. I went out to the barnyard to stomp on some chicks. They call me Wrecking Ball, 'cause I'm the baddest of them all. Got a bullet head and one stray eye. My back's been broken twice. I wear overalls and big old boots. My pants is filled with flies. Wrecking Ball, 'cause I'm the baddest of them all. I'll stomp on an egg, I'll stomp on a jug. Geese or Cornish hens, I don't give a. They call me Wrecking Ball, 'cause I'm the baddest of them all. Well, roosters and hens and all their feathered friends, they Well, everybody asks why I'm such a bastard. Well, wringing the necks ain't no fun, and stomping kills them fast, and they call me Wrecking Ball, 'cause I'm the baddest of them all. If your foul's gone foul, you can't count on Rover.
Gravy Boat, Season 2, Episode 3. That was The Knitters, The Call of the Wrecking Ball, off their 1985 album, Poor Little Critter in the Road. The Knitters, if you don't know, the punk band X. Most of the members of X also in The Knitters. Exene Cervenka, John Doe, DJ Bonebreak. They added Dave Alvin. Dave Alvin not in X, Dave Alvin in The Knitters, who you just heard a couple songs before that. Dave Alvin solo stuff from Blackjack David. You heard Abilene. Dave Alvin also in The Blasters. So, yeah, kind of hard to keep track. Dave Alvin and his brother Phil Alvin were in The Blasters. Dave Alvin was also in The Knitters. And Dave Alvin also had a solo career, and has a solo career. So, anyway, hard to keep track of that lineage. Also heard J.D. Wilkes. Brand new stuff from J.D. Wilkes. His new album out now called Fire Dream. You heard Rain and Snow. And I saw J.D. Wilkes and his legendary Shack Shakers last night here in Los Angeles at the Echo. Had a big all-day festival, Roots Roadhouse. And J.D. Wilkes and legendary Shack Shakers did a nice, unplugged set. As J.D. described it, a front porch setup. Very cool to see them. Right after the Shack Shakers, I saw this dude, Jesse Dayton, put on a hell of a show. From Austin, Texas, Jesse Dayton with Daddy Was a Badass. It's on the Gravy Boat.
All right. Well, Daddy was a badass, Oldfield white trash, never took nobody's lip. He was a honky-tonk dancer and even beat cancer, and 40 years smoking just quit. He had Corey and Penn up, black ink tattooed forearms from the war. He won a Purple Heart medal, but never heard him peddle the core. So they shipped him on home, his mind all blown, and nightmares about his past. Well, it's a dang good thing Mama met Daddy, 'cause Daddy was a badass. He met Mama on the dance floor in Deep East, Texas. She was the belle of the ball. He had a whole barren son giving him a run for her hand in marriage to call. So I took the rich kid to the back of the bar, threatened him with his life. He said, hey, little girl, your date had to leave, now you're gonna be my wife. I guess his country charm turned her on, 'cause 50 years has passed. He got the one and only girl in the whole wide world, 'cause Daddy was a man. Chili rig patch and gambling paid for school. The University of Texas sure got reckless, living on eight ball pool. He had back room all night poker games, a pistol by a rotary phone. He was a hot tip handicapper on football, never took a student loan. So he passed the honors by selling numbers to everybody in his class. Then he drove back home to Old East Texas. And he started his company. He made drilling bits for the old rigs and made a truckload of money. Hired all my uncles and the good old boys from back in his roughneck days. Now the shop burned down, lost everything he had, and he went to separate ways. Well, he flew to Vegas, he borrowed $5,000, and he put it on the red and black. He made 200 G's. He got the business back, y'all. Daddy retired, sold the business. The kids are grown and gone. He said, woman, I just can't sit around here. You know I gotta keep bringing it on. Climbed on this 1963 panhead, Harley Davidson, and rode it wide open till the end of the world, off a cliff and into the sun. What? Done with the world, man. Cause daddy was a badass. Cause daddy was a badass. Cause daddy was a badass.
Do you want to make big money? Say goodbye to creditors, unemployment, and poor paying jobs? Get out in a big rig and make big money.
I worked in a gas station. Then I got my class 1 truck driver's license. I have never been out of work since. You can have your license in 1 week.
Dudson driving schools are the best. Ask me. I'm Debbie Dudson.
18-wheeler fever, driving me home. I just keep on pulling, long about a heavy. Song about a truck driver's life, how he's so alone out on that open road, and it's hard for him to keep a wife satisfied at home. It's a damned old shame, and you know it is, when that love becomes a sacrifice. But a man's gotta do what a man's gotta. I do. There's two loves in a truck driver's life. Here's too much time for a man's mind to wander out on that old open road. He gets used to the whine and the hum of the wheels and the way they roll. And he loves that woman. When he's home, he's gonna give up on his time. When the bills roll in and the time begins, they gotta hit that old highway ride. 18-wheeler fever keeps him driving on. This old diesel's weaving all over damn old road. I'm gonna sleep with the one eye open. I gotta keep on making time.
You $10 if you sing into his can.
I'm not here to make a record, you dumb cracker. He broadcast me out on the radio.
Friend. Lost my best.
Welcome back to the Gravy Boat. It's me, Dave. Just heard stuff from Lucinda Williams from her second album way back in 1980. Happy Woman Blues was the album. You heard Howlin' at Midnight. Before that, Scott H. Byram, 18 Wheeler Fever from Graveyard Shift. And kicking that set off with Jesse Dayton, Daddy Was a Badass. Like I said last night, incredible show at the Roots Roadhouse 2018 here in Los Angeles. I don't know if they travel with that or what, probably not, but probably 20 bands on four different stages last night. J.D. Wilkes and the Shack Shakers, who I mentioned. Jesse Dayton was on there. Also, Scott H. Byram. Got to see him live for the first time. Been a fan of Scott for many years. Man, one-man band, just up there by himself with his guitar. He's got a kick drum. I think every now and then he breaks out a harmonica. Geez, might be a triangle or, I don't know, a didgeridoo or something. But, man, dude's a beast. Scott H. Byram, if you haven't checked him out, please do. Big fan. Oh boy, thank you so much for listening to the Gravy Boat, guys. I really appreciate that. Tell a friend if you're into this type of stuff, spread the word. I want this to be a cool thing. I don't want to overexpose it. I don't want to over advertise. I don't want dorks to listen to this. Just cool folks like you. Also, come see me do stand up. I'll be out the entire month of June doing my own stuff. And for about 2 weeks in May, I'll be out with my good buddy Kyle Kinane doing shows together. So all those dates can be found at dumbdavestone.com. Thanks for listening. Leave you guys with 16 horsepower. Ditch diggers on the gravy boat. See you next week. Out at your boy.
the gravy boat with Dave Stone.
That son of a bitch. He wouldn't know God if he crawled up his pant leg and beat him on the pecker. Change the damn channel.
I was walking down the street on a sunny day. Hubba, 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 hubba. A feeling in my bones says I have my way. Hubba, 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 hubba. Oh, I'm a happy boy.
Happy boy.
I'm a happy boy.
Happy boy.
Oh, ain't it good when things are going your way? Hey, hey. Yeah, my little dog Spot got hit by a car. Hubba, 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 hubba. Put his guts in a box and put him in a drawer. Hubba, 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 hubba. Oh, I'm a happy boy.
Happy boy.
Oh, I'm a happy boy.
Happy boy.
Oh, ain't it good when things are going your way? Hey, hey. Forgot all about it for a month and a half. Hubba, 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 hubba. I looked in the drawer and started to laugh. Hubba, 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 hubba. Cause I'm a happy boy.
Happy boy.
I'm a happy boy.
Happy boy.
Oh, ain't it good when things are going your way? Hey, hey.
Oh, Lord, yeah. Okay, thank you.